Thank you very much. The root cause happened the day we didn't go through the revolution and opted for negotiated settlement, where the political elite locked itself in a room and never shared the minutes with anyone. So we really don't know what really transpired, because they've spoken about everything else but economy. The economy was to remain intact, and some of the people even make jokes that the mining sector at the time said the clerk must remove apartheid, the exiles must return, and then business must go on as usual. Because those people were in a hurry to lead, they didn't bother with the details of what does that mean. So we came in 1994, and because there was a commitment of business as usual, we didn't tamper with anything. That's where the problem started.
Do you think we should go back there? Sorry, do we need another CODESA? How do we stop this hard act of brinkmanship, of blow for blow, like we saw last night? When does that end, Mr. Malema?
You need a political will, you don't need CODESA.
What do we need?
Political will.
Political will.
Yes,
the
must,
leadership.
Allow him to continue.
There must be a political will where leaders are able to take bold steps. We haven't seen that in South Africa. It has taken us more than 25 years to just establish a state-owned bank. You cannot do without funding. And they knew that very well from the beginning. These black people are being profiled in the banks. They've got brilliant ideas. They are being reduced to so-called SMMEs. They are being reduced to township economy, because theirs must start there and not compete with the mainstream big economy. Without funding, it was unimaginable for banks to fund black people during apartheid. It is still the same today. They can't finance you. They profile you and you become a suspect. What do? We don't go and stone ABSA. We don't go and stone FNB. We open our own bank.